Thanks, Sri Lakna, for the introduction. And firstly, I would like to thank the audience for showing interest in this topic and spending some time to attend this webinar. And the topic is the electronic credit note approval process in SAP. And please be informed, this is the completely the customized solution made for Novozymes South Asia Private Limited. And the basic agenda of this PowerPoint presentation is to give you an idea of implementing the workflow-based approval process in SAP by leveraging SAP workflows, ABAP programming, and SAP sales and distribution module. And also in this PPT, I'm going to cover how the approvals are going to be determined automatically based on the value of the credit note, and what are the different status reports developed as a part of this customized solution to Novozymes, and how the approvers could approve the credit notes using Outlook and mobile devices. So approvers can also approve the credit notes not only using SAP, but they can also approve the credit notes using electronic gadgets like mobile devices even. So certainly it's not possible to take you through the very detailed technical coding, but yes, I'll try my best to make this presentation as simple as possible. Yeah, what are the advantages in going for a solution like this, for a solution with an automated approval process built on SAP workflows? It is very faster and less time consuming. For example, if I have to take the approvals manually, it will be a very time consuming process. The approver might be sitting in some other country sometimes, and it could be in some other department as well. So certainly I need to take all the documents and then go to that person, or scan it and then send to the person, and then take his approval and initiate the process. So certainly there is a lot of manual intervention here, and it is going to be and it takes a lot of time, and it will have a better control on overview of approval process. We can even make sure that no users issue a credit note without approval process in place, and for better transparency and accountability. So at any given point of time, we can easily go through the statistics, like how many credit notes have been approved by a particular approver, or maybe how many credit notes are getting generated in a particular region. And also the compliance with external and as well as internal audits, because we have developed a couple of reports in this solution. So we have well-versed compliance with the internal and external audits, and also very easy for approvers to approve and reject. So they need not be having SAP, but still they'll be able to approve the credit notes using Outlook, as I told you in the earlier slide. So there could be some beginners attending this presentation or webinar. So before I get into further slides, I'm going to use the term called credit memo or credit note interchangeably. So here I made an attempt to give an exact definition of what is a credit memo exactly. So credit memos are requested during order processing in sales and distribution, and are used to clear amounts that are to be reimbursed. And also I have given you the reasons in which a scenario we issue a credit notes to the customers. Suppose if the customer complains that the price was miscalculated, in case of any price discrepancies, suppose I have issued an invoice to a customer with a very high price, and then I want to give back the price difference as a compensation, then I go ahead and issue a credit note to the customer. And sometimes in case the goods are damaged in transit and it's not worth taking the goods back, so in that case even I will go ahead and issue a credit note to my customer. And all the time, and also like if the customer complains, for instance, that goods were faulty, and you take the goods back and inspect, and you feel like, yeah, my customer has to be credited. So in that case also you issue a credit note. But in the last case, it need not always be issuing a credit note. It could be like you could even do a subsequent delivery free of charge, but there is an instance where you could even give a credit note to the customer. So this is how the credit memo request looks in SAP. But there is a difference between the credit memo and credit memo request. So credit memo is a billing document, whereas credit memo request is the sales document in SAP. This is how the credit memo request looks like, but it could vary from client to client. If you do some customization on this screen, it might look different for other clients. But more or less, this is a standard credit memo request look. And this is a sales document. So first, user will raise a credit memo request in the system. And once if it is approved by the approver, then user will try to convert this credit memo request into a credit memo, which is the billing document. Nothing but we have issued the credit note to the customer. So if you look at my screen on the top hand side left corner, you see an icon. That icon is called a services for object icon. That is a place where the user, where the initiator uses the icon to trigger the workflow. I mean, he'll go and start the workflow, meaning you are submitting this credit memo request for the approval. So you can see a lot of details on the screen, like the customer number, the customer name, and what are the different materials, and the value of the credit note. For example, you can see on my screen the value of this credit memo request is 1300 Malaysian ringgit. So you are going to make a request, and you are going to send this request for an approval to the approver to approve the request. Before the user sends the request for the approval, he or she will use this workflow icon to attach all the supporting documents necessary for the approver to go through all the details about this customer, and then could able to take a decision whether he or she could go ahead and approve this credit memo request. So once after the user attaches all the relevant documents here, he can even make a note why this credit memo request is going to be issued to the customer. And then once if they start the workflow, the approver will receive the mail saying that he or she needs to approve this credit memo request. But before getting to the approval process, I would like to brief you about a few important elements like partner functions. Basically, what is a partner function? Like any person who is involved in the business, with either directly or indirectly, is created as a partner in SAP. You could see the screen here. I mean, we are on slide number 6. And this screenshot has got all the information for the relevant partners related to this credit memo request. So this information is available on the header screen, the partners tab of the credit memo request. For example, here you can see the partner functions like sold to party, like he's the customer who is going to place an order for us. On the bill to party, he's the person or he's the customer who is going to receive the invoice. And the payer is the partner function who is going to pay in case of goods, and in this case it's a credit memo request, so we are going to pay him. And likewise, we have another partner function on the screen, that is ship to party. This function, this partner function, is going to receive the goods. So everybody, whoever is either directly or indirectly involved in the business, will be represented as a partner function in SAP. So every partner will have one unique ID, as you can see in the column called partner here. It is represented by a unique number. And I would like to tell you about the partner function sales representative here. So in our case, he's the person who will be in touch with the customer. So for example, if a sales representative is handling around 100 customers, So we are going to tag the sales representative to all these 100 customers as a partner function. Actually, all this data is maintained in the customer master. And when I create a credit memo request with reference to this customer, all the data will flow from customer to the change the credit memo request. So it doesn't mean like you have to enter all the partner functions individually in the credit memo request level. You maintain in one shot in the customer, and when you create a credit memo request with reference to this customer, all the partner functions will get copied to this credit memo request. And the more important partner function which I'm referring right now is the sales representative, which is a crucial partner function for this credit note approval functionality. So he's the person right now, for example, Rosa Kristen is the sales representative who is in touch base with this customer or who is responsible for this account. And I'm going to talk about output determination. So before I talk about output determination, we should know what is output type. Output type is nothing, output type is generally used to generate a printout, which will have all the information about that particular document in SAP. And this can be used as an internal document for our records, or you can even send it to the customer. If you send it to a customer, yes, it will be a legal document, or you can even have this printout for your records even. But in this case, credit note approval request is purely an internal document because it is not yet approved. This is the first document that is going to be created in the process of generating a credit note. I try to show you how the output looks like when we try to take the print of that particular output type. And here we are using the output type BA00. But we have modified the title to say that credit note approval request. So this will have all the information about this credit memo request. You can see the logo of the company and the title of the printout and who is the customer. But I could not take the screenshot of the complete printout, but at the bottom of the printout you also have the details about the materials and the value of the credit note and the registered office details. So everything you will have it. But certainly as of now, as I told you, this is not a legal document because this is not yet approved by approval. So I cannot share it with anybody. I have to keep it for internal reference. And yes, output. This output will be determined automatically based on the technique called condition technique, which is widely used in sales and distribution. And basically, we assign a procedure, output determination procedure, to the document type. Here in this case, the credit memo request. And this works on the technique called condition technique. And the third one is the billing block. So billing block on the credit memo request plays a very crucial role or a critical role by not allowing the initiator to go ahead with the invoicing without approval in place. Yes, the moment I create a credit memo request, by default, system will apply this block so that the initiator will not be able to create the credit note or will not be able to issue the invoice to the customer unless it is approved by the relevant approvers. And certainly, we made sure like no user will have access to remove this billing block. This concept of this can be purely handled by the authorization concept in SAP. So only very few users, like super users, will be having the access to remove the billing block, because in case of any workflow issues or any other technical problems, we don't want the business to suffer. So in this case, we can request the super users to override the billing block, and so that the user will be able to go ahead and create the invoice, that is credit note here. But in this automated solution, the block would be removed automatically in the background once after the final approvers approves the credit memo request. So there could be multiple approvers based on the value of the credit note. If value is very less, there could be one approver. If the value is very high, there could be multiple approvers to approve the credit memory. And also, once after the block is removed by system, system will automatically try to create the credit memo in the backend referring to the credit memo request. So always credit memo or the credit note is issued in the system with reference to the credit memo request which we are talking right now. So how to determine the approval?